Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Paathshala. In today's video, we are going to talk about what happens when the patient comes to you with a swelling, either with a buccal swelling or with a submantle sublingual swelling. So what happens? How do you come to know that which tooth is infected and what is the source and reason for the swelling? So today's video, we are going to talk about the space infection and the spread of infection. So without further ado, let's get started. So before we get started with the space infection in the maxillary teeth, we also have covered the space infection in the mandibular as well as in the impacted third molar. So before we get started, make sure to subscribe to our channel if you haven't done it yet and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of my future videos. So talking about space infection in the maxillary teeth, mandibular teeth we have already covered. Mandibular teeth, there is sublingual space, there is submental space, there is sublingual space, there is submandibular space, and then this is the going down, which is going down. Then the other side we have is the mesenteric space and the buccal space. This side we have is the pterygo mandibular space. Then we have is the parapharyngeal space. Then everything can go down into the parapharyngeal, then retropharyngeal, and then to the mediastinum. So it can actually be fatal. Talking about the maxillary space. So the maxillary teeth, the anterior teeth, actually all of the mandibular teeth were a kind of a same, because almost all of the mandibular anterior teeth are draining into the centrals, were draining into the submandibular, submental, and then all of the anterior teeth were basically draining into the sublingual. But also there can be associated swelling in the vestibule also is visible, because of the thinning of the buccal cortical plate, because the infection can either go down or it can spread outside. So it can go from the buccal cortical plate and go outside. So there are two cases, right? So the one important thing in maxillary teeth is that maxillary anterior, every teeth is different. Why every teeth is different? Because the maxillary lateral, see, because we have covered already in the endo videos, I have told you about the root anatomy while talking about the anatomy of the pulp cavity, that there is in the lateral root, there is a little bit curvature which is present. So there is a palatal curvature towards the root, is apex of the root is curved towards the palate. So there is chances of the palatal abscess that we have covered in that session also. So palatal, there are chances of the palatal abscess. And canine, if we look at, so canine we have is the canine space. We have already the different space which is present for the canine. And maxillary central, if we talk about, so mostly it can cause the vestibular, so the labial vestibular abscess or labial vestibular space infection. So there will be a swelling of the vestibule. So that is associated with the maxillary central. But if we look at the maxillary lateral incisor, then mostly it causes swelling in the palatal region in the deep inside. So if we look at the maxillary central, then there is going to be the swelling here. If we look at the lateral, there is going to be the swelling here. This is the difference between swelling between the maxillary central and the lateral. Then we'll talk about the canine space. So canine spaces, see, we have orbit, right? This is the and here we have is the lips. Okay, I have to draw big lips like this, right? Now we have canine here. So what happens? And also infravital foramen. So what happens when there is an infection in the root of the canine? There is caninus muscle, or we can say the levator anguli oris. So the levator anguli oris. So once it crosses this levator anguli oris, also we have levator labii superioris, which is connected to the orbit, so which is deep inside. So once it crosses this muscle, once the infection crosses this levator anguli oris, then we have here in this space region is the canine space. So in the canine space we have infravital foramen. From infravital foramen we have infravital nerve, right, passing. So any infection which enters here is going to enter in the orbital region. Any infection which crosses this muscle is going to go into the orbit. So it is going to cause the periorbital cellulitis. There is going to be the swelling all around the eyes, periorbital, so around the eyes. So and this, if you remember, when we give the infraorbital nerve block, we actually first perforate the levator anguli oris. Now if you feel that when we are going deep inside for infraorbital nerve block, when you have given the infraorbital nerve block, so first we penetrate this levator anguli oris and then we go deep inside. Then the next come the levator labii superioris, and when there is an infection which spreads between these, will go inside in the orbit. So this is the reason any infection in the canine, it can even cause swelling around the eyes. And this is the reason we are studying the space infection, because we want to know where it is causing the swelling. And for molars, we have the pterygomandibular ligament. So from hamulus of the upper and in the lower, it is going attached in the mylohyoid line, posterior end on the mylohyoid line. Up above we have is the maxilla, below we have is the mandible. So we have this buccinator muscle, right, this buccinator muscle. So actually this buccinator muscle is close to the, it arises from the apices of the roots of molars. So close to the molars. So any infection in the molars is going to go in this buccal space. Now this side we have is the superior constrictor pharynx. So any, see this is the buccinator, I have told you this previous also. The buccinator muscle, above every muscle is the skin. The space between buccinator and the superficial fascia of the skin is our buccal space. So any infection that can go, see this is the buccinator and above is the skin. So any infection in the molars can go in this buccinator space, and from this buccinator space even it can go to the parapharyngeal space. So this side in the pharynx, because this is the middle constrictor of the pharynx, so in the, it can go inside, see towards the midline. So it can go inside in the parapharyngeal space, again back, and it can go to the retropharyngeal space. So here back again in the parapharynx, then it can go, this is the vertebral column, suppose this is the vertebral column, then we have pharynx here, right, then here is the esophagus. So from the parapharynx it can go into the retropharynx. So here we have the buccal pharyngeal fascia towards the pharynx, and this side is the prevertebral fascia. So it will go into the retropharyngeal space, and this is the alar layer. So in the retropharyngeal space it can go into the dangerous area. So it can go deep inside and it can invade this mediastinum. So once it has invaded this, this is the center of the thorax cavity. So once it invaded into the thorax cavity, then in the thorax cavity, suppose till here is the esophagus, then we have, here is the sternum. So once it is reached here in the thorax cavity, we also have hurt pericardial vessels. So there can be difficulty in eating, difficulty in breathing. If it is involved with the esophagus, then there is going to be difficulty in swallowing, dysphagia. If it is involved the pericardial muscles, or pressure on the trachea if it is putting, then there can be difficulty in breathing, that is the dysphagia. Also it can cause dizziness and faint. So this is about the space infections. So maxillary, anterior, it can either go to the vestibule, go to the palate, or it can go to the canine space. Maxillary posterior, it can go to towards the buccal space. So if we look at the broad picture for both the space infection of the maxillary and mandibular teeth, so there is going to be the maxilla and the mandible. So from the maxilla, it can go up to the canine space, right? And it can cause periorbital cellulitis, or it can go to the buccal space, right? Mandible also, it can go to the buccal space, or it can go to the pterygomandibular space, right? And see, buccal space and pterygomandibular space, and mandible also, it can go to the submental, sublingual, submandibular, like this. And then from parapharyngeal, from there we have is the pterygomandibular, then it can go to the parapharyngeal. All of these spaces, buccal space can also drain into the it can also drain into the parapharyngeal space. So it can go into the parapharyngeal, then it can go into the retropharyngeal, then it can go into the mediastinum. So this is how every space in the oral cavity, basically if there is any infection in the tooth in the oral cavity, can result in the infection in the thorax deep down close to heart. So this is the reason that we are studying the space infection, and this is the reason this is a frequently asked question for you guys, because you should know that why and how it is spreading the infection. So this is about the space infection in the maxillary teeth. I hope that you guys have enjoyed the video, you guys have understood the video. So if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed to channel, then subscribe to it. What are you waiting for? If you enjoy watching to me, then. And you can also comment in the comment section below. And in the description below, now you have a chance to support me on PayPal and Paytm to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes for you guys. So thank you for that, and stay safe. I'll see you soon.